right, I'm at the house at White Pine Cove. And as you will see, and I'm going to try to give you a good feel of the surroundings, it's at the end, fourth house in, on a dead end lane. That is Fort Union, and the speed limit there is about 40 miles an hour. Great views, really nice Far East location. Lots of nice homes on this street, but there's only four. So if you look, so it's a little tougher the neighborhood feel. But I will say that this is what it looks like here. You're just looking right at a fence. I will say that this home is in really good condition inside. Nice remodeling work done, really good. And they've really priced it accordingly for the road. What strikes me at first is that the front door is actually on the side of the house. But that gives you a nice big garage and good parking. And I'm gonna go on in. Cool tree. But here's the front door on the side of the house. I'm just gonna get the backyard right now so I don't need to come back out. Nice landscaping, very green, really pretty back here, very private. Not a real big yard. Not a lot of playroom. It's a nice walking path. But a nice outdoor covered patio. I'm gonna walk. And so then again, I'm back into the front, and here's the front yard and the parking area. All right. This fence a little in rough condition. A lot of people's are because people salt them, so. All right, here's the front entrance. Nice front porch, very quiet at the front door. When you walk in, here's the staircase. And then you have a formal dining area and a more formal living area that walks through. This is what the floor looks like here, and it's nice and wide and flat, and it's no shine, and I really like it a lot. And this is what the dining and office flooring look like. And I like both of them a lot, actually. The green might have to go, but that's not a terrible job to do. And also the carpet upstairs, this is what it looks like. And so that would might be something that would need to go. Over here, you have a little half bath, the garage, and the stairs to the basement. It's really nicely remodeled. Nice granite. And honestly, the photos don't do these cabinets justice. They're very pretty and very well done. Like the floor coloring. Nice little bar sink over here. Scalloped edges on their granite in the corner. Double sinks here. Nice view. Lots of green. They did a really good job of camouflaging the fact that there's so many homes around. Another look at those, the cabinets, the granite. There's a bar. Nice built-in and a nice larger dining space with really cool cabinetry here for storage. Here's the floor in here. Same cabinetry in the back. They did the same granite as the kitchen. And here is the patio. They do have a cat.
Doesn't smell like pet anywhere I've been yet. This is arched here. All right, I'm gonna go upstairs. Nice wide staircase, not too steep. Fairly empty bedroom. Another bedroom. It looks like a queen size bed. Carpet in the bathroom. Not updated here. And not updated here. This looks like original work. But it seems to be relatively clean and in good condition. Here is the entrance to the master. Needs some paint. They tried to do touch up here and there and it didn't quite match. The windows are updated. Here is in the other, here's the master. Closet. Closet. Carpet. Garden size tub. Original shower. But fairly clean and fairly livable, minus the carpet, I would say. That would be the thing that I would wanna probably replace before I moved in. But no walls to move, no kitchen updating to do. Carpet can be done in 2 days. I'll go into the downstairs. I think the biggest downside is the fact that you're not in an actual neighborhood. Because if this home were in my neighborhood, which I'm just a half mile away, in a neighborhood, I think there would be a $25,000 price tag uptick on this house. Paint. Oh, actually, I didn't realize the basement wasn't finished, but here I am. Okay, they have two cats and a big unfinished basement. Here's plumbing for a bathroom. Lots of room for expansion down here. Washer and dryer are down here. Furnace looks pretty good. Hot water tank is large. This is probably under our front porch. Not nice diversity in the neighborhood. I live in it. Well, I think that for me, again, I feel like this house is in good condition compared to what I've seen in the neighborhood. And if you are okay with being on the, not a full neighborhood, but the quiet, well, I mean, the not super quiet, but the dead end street. Oh, that's where the cat's claw. So again, we're back to carpet and it desperately needs it. Here's the garage. A little oversized, a little pop out there. No problems with that either. So let me know what you think about this place. I think it's pretty decent. I think out of everything we've seen, I still like that house that was closer to the commercial area and the busier street a lot, but I think I would probably give this a pretty fair comparison to that one if I could live here or not. Maybe real quiet and you can hear the street.